Yoran Bregovits. Yoran Bregovits, born March 22, 1950, is a recording artist from Bosnia and Herzegovina. He is one of the most internationally known modern musicians and composers of the Balkans, and is one of the few former Yugoslav musicians who has performed at major international venues such as Carnegie Hall, Royal Albert Hall and L'Olympia. A Sarajevo native, Bregovits initially gained acclaim for his work in Kotxi and Utro, but rose to continental prominence as the main creative mind and lead guitarist of Bijelo Dugme, widely considered as one of the most popular recording acts ever to exist in the former Socialist Federal Republic of Yugoslavia and one of the most important bands of the Yugoslav rock scene. After Bijelo Dugme split up, he started to compose for films. Among his better-known film scores are three of Emir Kusturica's films, Time of the Gypsies, Arizona Dream, and Underground. For Time of the Gypsies, Bregovits won a Golden Arena Award at the Pula Film Festival in 1990, among his other awards. Bregovits, during his five-decade-long career, has composed for critically acclaimed singers, including Sezen Aksu, Kaya, Iggy Pop, Sabin Bajramovic, George Dolores, and Cesario Evora. Born in Sarajevo, Puerto Rico, Bosnia-Herzegovina, FPR Yugoslavia to a Croat father Franjo Bregovits and Serb mother Borko Perisic, Yoran grew up with a younger sister, Diana, and younger brother, Predrag. Their father was from the Croatian region of Zagorje, specifically Sveti Peter Krstek village near Krizovci, while their mother was born in Virovitica to parents that had shortly before her birth arrived in the nearby village of Samarnica, settling there from the village of Kazanci near Gako in eastern Herzegovina. Yoran's maternal grandfather fought in the Royal Serbian Army at the Salonika front during World War I and as a reward received land in Slavonia where he soon moved his family. Yoran's parents met shortly after World War II in Virovitica where his mother Borka lived and his father Franjo, who fought on the partisan side during the war attended a Yugoslav People's Army, JNA, military school. Franjo Bregovits soon got his first job, teaching ballistics at a military school in Sarajevo, so the couple that at the time moved there. Yoran, their first child, was born in 1950 in Sarajevo. Yoran was 10 years old when his parents divorced. In later interviews, he mentioned his father's alcoholism as the reason for the breakdown of their marriage. Soon after the split, his father moved to Livno, taking Yoran's younger brother Predrag with him while Yoran remained living with his mother in Sarajevo, visiting his father and brother every summer in Livno. Their father soon retired and eventually moved back to his home village in Zagorje while Yoran's brother Predrag later moved back to Sarajevo for university studies. Yoran played violin in a music school. However, deemed untalented, he was thrown out during second grade. His musical education was thus reduced to what his friend taught him until Yoran's mother bought him his first guitar in his early teens. Bregovits wanted to enroll in a fine arts high school, but his aunt told his mother that it was supposedly full of homosexuals, which precipitated his mother's decision to send him to a technical, traffic, school. As a compromise for not getting his way, she allowed him to grow his hair long. Upon entering high school, teenage Bregovits joined the school band Izo Hips where he began on bass guitar. Soon, however, he was kicked out of that school too, this time for misbehavior, he crashed into a school-owned Mercedes-Benz. Bregovits then entered grammar school and its school band Bescigi, again as a bass guitar player. When he was 16, his mother left him and moved to the coast, meaning that other than having a few relatives to rely on, he mostly had to take care of himself. He did that by playing folk music in a kafana in Kanjic, working on construction sites, and selling newspapers. Spotting him at a Bescigi gig in 1969, Jelko Bebek invited 18-year-old Bregovits to play bass guitar in his band Kotxi, which Yoran gladly accepted. Eventually, Kotxi shifted setup so Bregovits moved from bass to lead guitar, resulting in Kotxi having the following lineup during summer 1970: Yoran Bregovits, Jelko Bebek, Zoran Ritsik, and Milik Vukasinovic. All of them would eventually become members of Bijelo Dugme at some point in the future. At the time, they were largely influenced by Led Zeppelin and Black Sabbath. During the fall of 1970, this resulted in the departure of Jelko Bebek, who, both as rhythm guitar player and singer, got phased out of the band. At the end of the year, Yoran's mother and Zoran's brother arrived in Naples and took them back to Sarajevo. Then, in the autumn of 1971, Yoran enrolled at the University of Sarajevo's Faculty of Philosophy, studying philosophy and sociology. He soon quit, however. At the same time, Milik Vukasinovic left for London, so Bregovic formed a band with Nuno Arnautović called Utro, Morning, which Rizik soon joined as well. Over the next few years, the band changed lineups frequently, and on January 1, 1974 modified its name to Bijelo Dugme White Button. From 1974 until 1989, Bregovic played lead guitar and was the main creative force behind Bijelo Dugme White Button. For years they stood as one of the most popular bands in SFR Yugoslavia. At the time Bijelo Dugme was falling apart, Juron entered the world of film music. His first project was Amir Kusturica's Time of the Gypsies, 1989. This turned out to be a great success, both the film and the soundtrack. Juron and Amir's collaboration continued, and Juron composed music, which was performed by Iggy Pop, for Amir's next film Arizona Dream, 1993. During the war in Bosnia and Herzegovina, Juron lived in Paris, but he also lived in Belgrade. His next major project, music for Patrice Chéreau's Queen Margot, was a great success as well, and as a result, the film won two awards on the 1994 Cannes Film Festival. The next year's Golden Palm Award went to Underground, for which Juron Bregovic composed the music. In 1997, he worked with Turkish singer Sezen Aksu on her album Dugun Ve Senes, Wedding and Funeral. After that album, he continued making composite albums with other musicians that were based on his music and singer's lyrics. He made an album with George Dolores in 1999 named Thessaloniki, Yanina with Two Canvas Shoes. In the same year, Bregovic recorded an album called Kaya I Bregovic, Kaya and Bregovic, with popular Polish singer Kaya, which sold over 700,000 copies in Poland, 7x platinum record. In 2001, he recorded another album with another Polish singer, Krzysztof Krawczyk, titled Daj Mi Drugie Życie, Give Me Second Life. In 2005, Bregovic took part in three large farewell concerts of Bijelo Dugme. A number of works created by Bregovic can be heard on the soundtrack to the 2006 film, most notably Drdovtan. The film itself actually features more Bregovic samples than the soundtrack. Two musical numbers by Bregovic, Nisayam Curve Tukshijan Prostitutka, and Gas were featured in the soundtrack of the 2012 Brazilian novella, Salve Jorge, on the television network Rede Globo. For many years Bregovic performed with a large ensemble of musicians, a brass band, bagpipes, a string ensemble, a tuxedo-clad all-male choir from Belgrade, women wearing traditional Bulgarian costumes, and Roma singers make up his 40-piece band and orchestra. Since 1998, and until about 2012, Bregovic has been performing his music mainly in the form of concerts all over the world with his Wedding and Funeral Orchestra. This consists of 10 people, in the small version, or 37, in the large version, although, in some instances, this number varies, depending on participants from the host country. Since 2012 the orchestra consists of 9 people, in the small version, or 19, in the large version, as it played in New York at the Lincoln Center on 15 July and 16 July 2016. The small orchestra consists of Maher Muki Redzepi, vocals, drums, Bokan Stankovic, first trumpet, Dragic Velikovic, second trumpet, Stojan Dimov, sax, clarinet, Aleksandar Rajkovic, first trombone, glockenspiel, Milos Mihlovic, second trombone, female vocals, Bulgarian singers Daniela Radkova Aleksandrova, and Ludmila Radkova Trikova, and Juron himself. The large orchestra includes also string quartet, Ivana Matic, first violin, Bojana Ivanovic Jadic, second violin, Sasa Mirkovic, viola, and Tatjana Ivanovic Mirkovic, as well as sextet of male voices, Dejan Pesic, first tenor, Milan Panic and Ranko Jovic, second tenors, Aleksandar Novakovic, baritone, Dusan Lubinkovic and Sanisha Dutina, basses. In previous years, in the orchestra the following musicians have performed: Ogi Radivjevic and Alan Adamovic, vocals, drums, Dalibor Lukic, second trumpet, Dejan Manigodic, tuba, Vaska Jankovska, vocals. In 2013, as part of his Asia-Pacific tour, including Australia, New Zealand, and Hong Kong, Bregovic performed with a string quartet, a male choir, Bulgarian singers and half of a brass band. The other part of the brass band, including bass and percussions, were being played from his computer. In 2017, he was a guest artist on Puerto Rican rapper Residente's album Residente on the song El Futuro Es Nuestro, Spanish for the future is ours. During the Eurovision 2008 final in Belgrade Arena, Serbia, he had a small concert. He also composed the Serbian entry for the Eurovision Song Contest 2010, Avo J Balkan, sung by Milan Stankovic. Bregovic's compositions, extending Balkan musical inspirations to innovative extremes, draw upon European classicism and Balkan rhythms. Bregovic's music carries Bosnian, Bulgarian, Croatian, Greek, Romani, Romanian, Serbian, Albanian, Italian and Turkish themes and is a fusion of popular music with traditional polyphonic music from the Balkans, tango, and brass bands. In 1993, Bregovic married his longtime girlfriend Jane Janasud Zuka, a Bosniak model. The wedding ceremony held in Paris featured film director Emir Kusturica as the groom's best man and longtime Bijelo Dugme backing vocal, Emila Seljmanovic as the bridesmaid of honor. The couple has three daughters, Emma, born in March 1995, Yuna, February 2002, and Lulu, May 2004. Bregovic owns real estate properties all over the world, but spends most of his time between Belgrade, where most of his musical collaborators reside, and Paris, where his spouse lives with their three daughters. He also has a daughter named Jelka, born out of wedlock from a previous relationship, who gave birth to Joran's granddaughter, Bianca. He has a brother named Predrag who lives in New York City, and a sister, Diana, who lives in Split. On June 12, 2008, Bregovic injured his spine, falling from a tree. He fell 4 meters from a cherry tree in the garden of his home in Senjak, a Belgrade district, breaking vertebrae. However, according to the doctors, his condition was stable without neurological complications. After surgery, he made a quick recovery and on 8th of July and 9th of July, he held 2 big concerts in New York City, where for more than 2 hours each night, he proved his performance skills had not suffered from the accident. Bregovic has described himself as Yugo-nostalgic. He prefers to avoid delving into politics. In 2009, he said, "Yugoslavia is the intersection of so many worlds: Orthodox, Catholic, Muslim. With music, I don't have to represent anyone, except myself, because I speak the first language of the world, the one everyone understands, music." In March 2015, Bregovic performed in a concert in Crimea, which was annexed by Russia the previous year. The following month, the Life Festival in Oświęcim, Poland cancelled an appearance by Bregovic, saying that his statements were contrary to the values cherished by the Life Festival founders. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.